In the last section, we discussed the deer antler, which is always made available to your puppy. Now, I want to talk about using compressed rawhides in a more strategic way. The big difference between the compressed rawhide and the deer antler is that the compressed rawhide is consumable. This makes it a higher value resource for your puppy. Since it does carry more weight when it comes to getting and keeping your dog's attention, we use it a bit differently. Both with deer antlers and compressed rawhides, it's a big puzzle piece, and not just the management aspect of our training, but it also helps meet your puppy's primal needs, much like tug and fetch and off-leash hikes. So compressed rawhides are kind of like plywood in that it's a bunch of smaller pieces that are fused together, and it's held together with an outer shell. Compressed rawhides come in itty bitty little couple inch sizes for toy breed size puppies, and it comes in 12 inch long sizes for the big dogs. If your dog is about 20 pounds, you can use the 6 to 8 inch ones. If your dog is about 30 pounds, use the 8 to 10 inch ones. If your dog is 40 pounds, the 10 inch one should fit the bill. And if your dog is 50 plus pounds, stick with the 12 inch ones. You'll get the most bang for your buck. No matter what size you buy, you have to monitor your dogs while they chew. This isn't something you should just throw in their crate and leave for work. Some dogs will attempt to swallow the bones way too soon, and you can expect that if you have a dog who has a real high food drive or is constantly trying to chew and swallow inappropriate items already, that this dog is probably going to be one of those that you have to watch. At first, your goal should be to gauge when your dog attempts to swallow it, and then take it away before it gets to that length. A small percentage of dogs who do have sensitive stomachs get diarrhea from consuming rawhide. You probably know already if your dog falls into this category before you introduce this, so just be extra cautious. I recommend buying one and then trying it out and take it from there. You can adjust the size and then buy a bunch if it works out. I typically recommend to my clients to use these high value bones in tandem with time in the crate. I love putting a puppy in the crate and then giving him a bone while I'm cooking dinner or working on the computer or just doing things around the house. And that will allow you to not have to be in puppy training mode. The compressed rawhide and crate combo is a great way to put your puppy on autopilot and have you work smarter and not harder. Keep watching to learn how to turn these otherwise ordinary tools into extraordinary time-saving tools. We'll see you in the next section.